Good afternoon, this is the port side anchor of the vessel and this is the forward winch and windlass arrangement. Today we will be discussing in detail about dropping an anchor in practical. So these are the mooring ropes and this is the warping drum. Each of this can be individually selected using the gear arrangement. I will show it to you as we go along. So now this is the windlass and the gypsy, and you can see the spurling pipe. The anchor chain comes out from the chain locker through the spurling pipe to the gypsy and goes out through the hose pipe. This is the hose pipe and its cover. This is my ship's bow stopper. It is basically used to take the strain of the windlass, that is the weight of the anchor and the cable of the windlass. And this is how you engage and disengage any gear on a windlass or a winch. So the next thing is, this is the controls of the winch. Now let us practically drop an anchor. The bridge has ordered port anchor to be ready for letting go, so we will open the bow stopper. So the bow stopper has been opened. Now the gear will be engaged and the brakes will be opened, and slowly we will lower the anchor to around 1 meter above water level for letting go. Why we keep it clear of the hose pipe is to prevent any damage to the hose pipe. Now the gear has to be disengaged, so we will again tighten the brakes, and once the brakes are tight, we'll slowly move the winch a little bit so that the gear is off weight, and slowly we take the weight off the gear and the gear is disengaged. And as you can see, now the anchor chain is holding just by the brakes. Now we'll wait for the bridge to give us instruction to let go.
Cockpit cap, let go port anchor.
Two shackles, hold on.
Two shackles, hold on. Okay boss.
I have taken shots from multiple angles to show you how dangerous is the surging of the anchor chain once the anchor is let go.
Holding on.
Okay. Now.
Okay. 7 o'clock. Very short stay.
Along your flag to shackle on deck. Okay.
3 shackles on deck, cap. Cycle on the cap. Now we are going to the final 4 shackle on deck. So the 3rd shackle just passed. Now how I'll show you how to understand the 4th shackle. So the 4th shackle, whenever it comes, the joining shackle will be in the middle, and the next 4 links to both sides will be having white paint and will be having a marking. Our ship's paint has already been gone, so you can see the metal clip that will be 4 links away from the joining shackle. That is how you will understand the fourth shackle.
Four shackle on deck, 7 o'clock, very short stay kept.
Now the final reporting that we have to do after dropping an anchor is to report if the vessel has been brought up to her anchor or not. So it's very simple. As you can see, the chain is slowly taking the weight. Once the chain starts taking the weight, it will start stretching. So since we have used the port anchor, the possible directions will be only from 7 o'clock to 12 o'clock. So you can see the chain has slowly started taking the weight. It is stretching to around medium stay. So it has gone up from short stay to medium stay, and 12 o'clock has reduced to 11 o'clock. It will slowly come down to around 10 o'clock also, and this medium stay will reduce to a short stay. That means the anchor has taken, anchor is holding the ground and the vessel is riding to her anchor. Now I'll show you the angle reduction. Now it's around short stay at 10 o'clock. In a few moments it will come down to a very short stay at 10 o'clock. That means she is already brought up. So once the vessel is brought up, that means there is no more chances of dragging. You can see it is very short, 10 o'clock, and finally it is up and down. Now we will close the bow stopper, take the anchor off gear for emergency let go, and close the hose pipe cover. I believe you got a good understanding. Thank you.